What can I say? New Orleans. We love her.
When the night comes and I'm able, I can see you across the table. You're a shooting star staring at me. I'm paranoid now. Why are you laughing? So I called you just to call you.
Mr. Ben Elman and Chris Finney. Yeah, they, you know, they're just easy to work with and they get us. They get what we want to do.
It's just so much easier when you've built a rapport with somebody before, and we love the work we did with them before, so we wanted to expand on that.
One of the danger spots is keeping 10 people focused at the same time. You got 7 incredibly creative dudes, and then you add the rest of us into it. So making sure that stays in balance, there's really something to that. Ben's got the chops for that. Really, really.
I had this idea for this riff and this music that was kind of a little dark. And then we kind of went into the studio and Dave wrote some lyrics to it, tied it together very well and gave it a hook.
Hello, can anyone hear me?
You know, and the idea of it is you have this person maybe in your life that they're trying to call you out, and no matter what you do, you can't convince them that you're the person that you think you are. And eventually you just kind of give up. You just almost accept that that's just what this person is going to think, and there's nothing you can really do about it.
We're just always throwing out these musical allusions in the process that we love and that moves us and inspires us. And we have no problem just throwing all that into the pot.
The sun itself is colorblind to the light. It's burning out somehow.
I watch it pass. It's kind of a lot of imagery in that one. And I think I just kind of got into a flow and wrote a lot of lyrics. And the We Can Work It Out sort of positive chorus. You know, we're not heroes, but we just work it out. You know, we work, address our issues. You know, we can be all right. And then just like look up to the sky, like aim high, you know, navigate below means keep your head on the ground sort of thing and deal with it one step at a time. There's also a lyric in there where it might be a little bit of like an arrogant thing, like you think you heard something. It's just the jingling of my spare keys. You'll see what's coming.
Rob had an idea of a horn part, and I came in and we kind of made it from, you know, his horn part into a section part, and you know, we fleshed it out a little bit more. I sat in front of the organ and they'd pull up a song and I'd play it like 2 or 3 times, and then we'd go to the next song.
I've always liked being an energetic presence on stage. I always think it's kind of important to if you're not going crazier than the people in the audience, or else they're not going to realize that it's okay for them to be going crazy.
We were writing them a lot in the studio, so it was very much like, all right, let's just like get this song down with this feel and this way. I like catching that creative moment even better than like if the song is played perfectly, is like the moment the song was like really freshly solidified.
It's a masquerade. With all the troops out.
I'll just tell you the truth. I wrote 3/4 of that song while I was walking a parade. And the lyric about the nightmare. Passed by City Hall, caught a glimpse of the nightmare dressed in black, taking nips from a flask filled with cognac. That was a float going by, and it was Mayor Ray Nagin all messed up looking, taking a big sip. You know?
It's a masquerade with all the troops.